Sorry guys, I just keep getting a ton of interruptions and I'm trying to do this vlog on my phone and stuff, or this chit chat, whatever you want to call it. Sorry about that. But yeah, we were talking about dictating people's lives. I don't think that anybody would like anybody dictating their life.
Okay, I know as women we like to always tell people what, I mean, as women we like to tell men what to do. But the men should have the leader role in our family. You know, that's how it was from the beginning of time, since we were created. You know, but a man should also, you know, respect his wife and treat him as an equal, not treat him, you know, this is something I've learned in church. The man doesn't walk in front of the woman. The man doesn't walk behind the woman. The woman actually walks right by the man's side. So the man shouldn't, you know, be treating you bad, and you shouldn't be treating him bad. You know, you guys need to learn to respect one another and treat one another the way you would want to be treated. So dictating a person's life is not going to get you anywhere. In fact, you're going to tire that person out. And I've talked to a lot of couples, and not just in my family, but people I know and stuff. And you know, their complaints about one another are usually the same. Sometimes you do have some that are different. I mean, there could be cheating involved. But from what I've gathered, men don't think that they really cheat unless they're actually doing something physically with a woman. Them cheating, their mentality of cheating is not just talking to somebody. Talking is one thing, and actually touching another woman or physically being with that woman is considered cheating for them. Cheating is having any other person in your mind that is not the person you're with, like your wife. And that's how we women think, but men think slightly different. But anyway, we're not going to get into all that. Cheating is cheating, and when you choose to unite your life with somebody else's, where you start having children and stuff, you know, you need to respect that person. And respecting by not thinking about anybody else, by not talking to anybody else, by not just doing anything that you know you wouldn't want being done to you. So yeah, I just kind of had that in the back of my mind. I was kind of like, you know, you hear them both, you hear both of the, like, I heard both of their sides and stuff, and I think that they are just completely missing each other. They both want the same thing, yet they don't want to fold. When you don't fold, you end up losing a good thing. Pride is not good. Pride, I know, I'm still working on it. I'm still working on it. I know. I mean, but I do it. I fold because of my kids. I fold because I love my husband. I fold because I want my kids to grow up with their father. I wouldn't want them to not have a person who is really, really important in their lives. So anyway, yeah. I don't know if I'm going to be continuing to do these kind of vlogs, but you know, it was just something to think about. I think that I'm hoping that, you know, it helps some of you out there. If you guys are having problems in your marriage or things like that, reach out and talk to somebody, you know, like, get counseling. You know, you can get counseling from church, you can get counseling from people who are positive, who have the their best interest in your relationship, not people who are going to be telling you, get out of the relationship, you know, you don't need to take that. Talk to people who are positive and not so negative, and take a step back and look, you know, am I really being selfish? Am I really just thinking about myself, or am I thinking about our whole family? Am I really thinking about, you know, what's best for us and not just for me, you know? Because it's not just you you're affecting. You're affecting your whole family. And if you are going to make the decision to part and make separate lives, take different paths, do it gracefully. Try to do it in the best way that you can. I know that it's hard, but do it for the kids. I mean, because ultimately they are the ones that end up suffering in the end, you know? When you do take a step back and look at...
If I were to walk away from a situation, I think that I would think really, really long and hard as to why I was doing it, because I don't want to have that what if in the back of my mind. What if we would have worked in those? What if I would have listened to him? What if, you know, I would have tried harder? It's better to try as much as you can. And while you think you might get hurt and you might have lost a lot of time, like a lot of years that passed by or whatever, ultimately, you know, the Lord will bless you. If you were faithful and you did everything you could and you know, you did the best you could to be the best wife or the best person in the relationship, then the Lord will bless you. And if you are one of those people that are selfish and don't care and you cheat and you lie and you do all these bad things, you don't respect your relationship and you just completely use the other person, and you know, eventually that's what you're going to end up getting. You're going to end up getting exactly what you did to that person. And usually it comes twice as bad, which is usually called karma. So I wouldn't worry too much about that. I would just try being the best person, you know, in the relationship. Just do your best. You know, learn to compromise. Learn to respect. Learn to not dictate the other person's life. Learn to, you know, work together as a team. You know, a lot of the times people do not get married. You know, they just the difference between a marriage and people that have just start living together and just start having kids together is that a marriage usually chooses, people who get married usually choose, and they know that they're going to put their lives together to become a we, to become an our. You know, it's no longer my this or I want to do this. No, it's not like that. And that's the difference between a lot of couples nowadays that become, you know, they just start living together and they start having kids together, and then they feel that they can run out whenever they want and that they don't have to, you know, take any other, that they can pick up and leave whenever they want. Like if, it ends up being a lot messier. For me and my husband, we decided to unite our families. I mean, our families, yeah, but unite our lives together, and we became a we, and everything's an our. It's not my this and my that, and you never really hear that. That's, we talk about our kids, we talk about our truck, we talk about our, you know, apartment, our everything, our bank account, our, you know, our money. It's not about my money, my room, my truck, my car, it's my children. It's not like that. It's I don't know. I'm very passionate about a subject of marriage. I believe that there needs to be a lot of respect. Do not do unto others that you would not want done unto you. So that's the message for today. Hopefully this helps you guys out in some way. Hopefully you guys learn to respect the person that you're with. Learn to love that person for who they are. You got together with them for a reason, you know. Looks fade in the end. You know, we are all going to be old one day. you don't know what life has in store for you. You know, things change, you know, and you need to, if you really love that person, if you would accept them with all their flaws and you would help them through their tough times, you wouldn't put them down and look at them like, you know, like, let's say you've gained some weight. Well, dang, you know, like, really? Like, I mean, I've been with my husband. He's been, when I married my husband was a big, big man. He was weighing 280. And then diabetes ate him up and he dropped down to 180. You know, he was really, really skinny and people were kind of like, what's wrong with him? You know, like, why is he so skinny? And, you know, my husband almost had his toe amputated and I still would have been with him through that. What I'm saying is learn to love the person for who he is, not for what he looks like on the outside, not for, I just think people have just lost their sense of putting in the work. People don't want to put in work anymore. And I am glad that I had a good example and I had my parents and they pushed through all the tough times. And that is why I guess I hold on to my marriage. I hold on to my marriage because I had good examples. And if you want your relationship to last and you want your relationship to work out, then you need to put in the work, whether that be 5 years, 3 years, 10 years, 12 years, 20 years. That's what marriage is. That's what relationships, long-lasting relationships take. It takes work. It takes not being selfish. It takes respect. It takes allowing people to live their lives and not dictating them. It doesn't mean not putting them in their place if they make you feel bad. It doesn't mean you can't tell the person, you know, we have to pay this or we have to pay that, because those are things that we need to do. But it means don't tell them, you know, if they like to play video games, don't tell them they can't, you know, let them play a little bit. But if it's really becoming a problem and it's interfering completely, then you do need to say something so that they know, you know, you want to spend time with them, but don't tell them what they can or what they can't do. Don't put your, like, for me, like, don't be putting them down all the time, because they will be hearing compliments on the other side. And as women, I would say, take care of yourselves. You know, be the woman that he fell in love with. You might not be that exact same woman, because as a woman, you change physically, mentally, physically because you start having babies and stuff. But learn to get that person back. Don't let yourself go and become so mommy-ish. You will always be a mom, but learn to still be yourself. Learn to love yourself. Learn to respect yourself. Learn to value yourself. You know? Anyway, guys, if you guys enjoy these kind of videos, let me know. I will definitely do more. But, you know, yeah, I just had that on my mind. And I wanted to help other people out. I want to see more marriages succeed and relationships succeed. I feel like we're losing, you know, we're losing good, stable homes, and that's not something that I want to see. I don't want to see that happen, because, you know, our children need stable homes. They need good examples. They need to see good examples at home so that they can have a good relationship and they won't be so afraid to commit when they get older. Anyway, guys, I don't want to make this any longer. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye, guys.